Good to be back here at the IMAX Cinema here in Lekki Phase 1. This is the Filmhouse TV show, guys. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Now, as you know, this is the month of love. I love love. I don't know about you guys, but we're going to bring you a lowdown of everything from the box office. Don't go anywhere. And of course, at this point, I think you should say after me, luxury. Yes, luxury. Repeat after me, luxury. Because that's what you get when you book the queue with that special someone. You know, that's the perfect place to be here on Valentine's Day. So we'll be giving you an insight of what you get when you book the queue. Don't go anywhere, guys. This is the Filmhouse TV show. My name is Chinonso Aribai. Follow me. Come with me, guys. Guys, so this is the cube, very cute and cozy. I know, it's really lovely. It feels like a mini bedroom, or I don't know, it's really, really amazing. Makes you just want to just lean back and watch a good movie with your popcorn. And you know what's even incredible is the fact that these chairs can actually be converted into a bed. So we have an attendant here who would help you do that, you know, take away the stress so you don't break your nails while you're trying to pull it out and, you know, convert it into a bed. And this place is made up of as many as five speakers, more than five. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 speakers. So the sound is amazing. We have this huge, massive screen here where you can get to watch your movie, but you can't really compare to what you have at home, because I know you'd be like, oh, I have a big TV at home. But this is different. By the time you combine this incredible sound to this massive screen, then you'd have a special treat. Now, when you're done, just in case you want to, you know, use the restroom, you don't need to go all out and worry about the crowd coming downstairs, probably thinking you would fall down the stairs. You just have this restroom here. Very nice. When you're done eating, because when you book the cube, you actually have a buffet. It's not even a mini buffet, a buffet, a platter of meals, over 7 plates of meal options. So when you bring you and that special someone to the cube, you get scrumptious meals, you get popcorn, nice drinks, and of course you have your privacy, which is very key, especially if you're thinking of proposing to that special someone and you don't know if she'll say no, or should I say you don't know if he'll say no, because all kinds of things are happening right now. So the cube is just a place to be, especially this season of Valentine, Christmas, Easter, whenever it is you feel like, you know, having that special time with you and your family. It could be with you and your friends. You guys just want to chill, you want to hang out. This is the place to be, guys. And of course, it's the only place where you're actually allowed to have food in the cinema. Yeah, you get to eat really nice food. I feel like sleeping here because it's so cozy. If you're cold, you have the blankets laid out. Don't forget, I told you that you can pull out these chairs and convert them into a bed. So I think I should just take a break, if my producers will allow me. Oh, I have to complete my task before I forget. We have a mystery guest, so I'm going on to the Signature Lounge. Follow me, guys.
Coming up this week, we have the movie rundown of what's hot in cinemas, and then the Fan Zone segment with a very special guest. We can't wait to show you who our special guest on the show is today. So stay with us through this journey. It's a surprise. Don't go anywhere.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you?
Thank you.
What's your name?
Tami Tokwe.
Okay, so I'm sure you're familiar with the Big Brother Nigeria TV show.
Yes, of course. I'm Nigerian, yes, of course.
Okay, and you love it, like you follow it, you've watched it.
Well, I don't really follow it, but I do, like, you know, work in your house and you see people watching it.
So how much do you think is reality on TV? On the show, I mean.
Not much, you know, if we're trying to be honest, you know. But, you know, when you stay in a house for like 3 months, right? Yeah. Of course, some of, you know, it gets real at a particular point, so yeah.
Hello, ma.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How are you today?
I'm very fine, thank you.
Okay, so are you here to see a movie?
Yeah.
What movie I hate?
Ferdinand.
Nice, nice, very interesting. So on today's episode of the Film House TV show, we're expecting a mystery guest. One of the clues that he was actually on Big Brother Nigeria. So could you guess who it is? It's not Bisola, it's somebody else. And his name starts from B. It starts with the letter B. And he's a DJ and an actor. Can you guess?
Could that be Bayo?
Very close, actually, very, very close, but it's not him. But very close. He's a DJ, he's from Kaduna, and what else?
DJ.
That's a B.
That's a that guy, isn't it? Bali.
Yes, I like you. You know your shows.
The guy. DJ. That's very infallible. Soma.
No, his name starts with B.
Bali.
Yay! I have a winner.
Okay, all right.
Thank you. It's time for Film Focus, guys. This is the part of the show where we focus on a particular movie, and today we're focusing on the movie 50 Shades Freed. Now, finally, Kristen and Anastasia finally get married, but Jack Hyde would not allow their marriage be great, if you know what I mean. This movie stars Dakota Johnson, Ariel Cabell, and Jamie Dornan. I really can't wait for you guys to see this movie. If you're familiar with the 50 Shades series, then this is the one that you want to watch. You need to come out to see this movie. All right, guys, check it out. Let's see what it's like.
Good morning, wife.
Good morning, husband.
Don't ask me,
Mrs. Gray. Look out your window.
What you know is true.
I'm taking you away for the weekend.
I just can't believe this is my life that I get to live with you.
Oh, I love your precious heart.
It meant nothing to me before you.
Anna Gray's office. We wanted to welcome the new fiction editor.
I bought it for us. I should have asked you first.
I love it. Oh my God.
Christian.
This is Gio Matteo, the architect.
This location is perfect. I'm going to build you a fabulous house.
Please stop speaking to my husband as if I weren't here.
Anna.
You may call me Mrs. Gray.
I'll pick you up at 5.
I might not be done by then.
We're being followed.
How the hell are you, Anna?
Jack, what do you want?
So you want to play?
Yes, sir.
I made a vow to love you faithfully, forsaking all others.
Did you sleep with her?
To comfort you in times of need, and to keep you safe for as long as we both shall live.
Alright, guys, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time for my big reveal. Yes, I have an ex-Big Brother housemate on the hot seat. Like you can see, this seat looks like a Big Brother house seat. But you know what? This guy is stunning, actually. I didn't even know he was this good looking in person. And I'm not checking him out, don't worry. And he's such a stylish young man, if I do say so myself. All right, guys, I have with me the man, the myth, the DJ, the actor, DJ Ballet.
Myth, legend, everything. All right. You if now? You say so.
Hello. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you doing today?
I'm fine. Thank you. So what have you been up to, DJ Ballet, since you left, you know, the Big Brother house? What have you been up to? How has life been?
Life has been different. I'm sure you can understand what I mean, but
with the chicks or different or what? How do you mean different?
The chicks have actually always been there, but I'm just kidding. I mean, yeah, life is different in the sense that people know you now. You know, you can walk up on the street and people recognize you. There are definitely more doors open. So basically, I've just used the platform to continue doing what I've been doing since, which is DJing. I've been trying out the voiceover thing, so I'm getting to like that, and then also the acting thing. Even though last year I kind of had a problem with the acting thing because I kept getting gigs, but my schedule couldn't allow me to focus. But this year I want to focus more, a little bit more on that. Mm-hmm.
So where did that name come from, and what's your full name? Like, is it Bali Chuku Olua Bali? Where did Bali come from? I don't know.
Okay, my real name is Bobai Balat.
Where's that name from?
I know, right? You haven't heard it before. I'm from Kaduna, but even in Kaduna is a unique name, even back home. But yeah, that's my name. And Bali comes from my surname, which is Balat. So when I was in secondary school, actually, it didn't come from me. My elder brother was called Bali. After he graduated, they now started calling me Bali. But then I decided to take the name, global.
Name yes. Thief.
But
Bobai Balat.
Yes.
What does Bobai mean? Is that English?
Is my language. It's not even Hausa.
What does it mean?
It's Katuf. Katuf. Yeah. So yeah, it means he has come back.
So have you done any movie in particular?
Not any ones that not yet. But I used to act. I actually went to a Royal Arts Academy.
Wow.
So yeah,
nice.
Some years back. So that's where I got my acting start from.
Okay, nice. That's really good. So if you were to go to a cinema with somebody, who would that be? And what's the preferred time of the day that you like to go?
Who would that be? I think I'll actually it might be my guys. Actually, like, I think I'd rather watch movies with my guys.
People will be looking at you funny now. Dude, bruv. Ladies,
don't get it.
Do the ladies stand?
Look, don't get it twisted. I'm not one of those. I don't view the cinema as the ideal date scenario. I'm a movie buff.
Okay.
So when I come to watch a movie, I want to focus on my movie, enjoy my movie, be in the movie, So I think a date is really a distraction for me. So I'd rather let's just go out, let's have drinks, let's do other things, but not the movie.
Okay, so what time of the day perfect for you?
I would say the ideal time for me, because I don't like the cinema to be too crowded. So I would say probably around 2-3 in the afternoon.
Okay. If you were to run a cinema yourself, and you wanted to introduce something new, like a new innovation, what would it be to the cinema industry right now?
A new innovation.
Yeah, that you'd like to introduce.
That's a tricky question. I think the only thing is, I actually enjoy the cinema experience already as it is, but maybe if there's more food variety. You know, as beyond the popcorn and Coke or whatever they have. Yeah. I think more just having more variety. And sometimes that's why I prefer to stay at home sometimes than watch a movie, because I feel like when I'm at home, I can sit down, eat my food, watch the movie, relax, everything. So I just feel like that experience would be.
Yeah, I know a couple of people who believe like if there's no food while you're watching TV, it's not complete.
It only makes smuggle food into the cinema just because of that, So
we need to beef up the security.
Right.
So I'll take note of the food part because I really, really love that part.
Right.
But supposing you wanted to, set up a cinema in a community cinema in any location or any state of your choice, where would it be?
That's interesting. And I think that's a very good question because, when I was growing up in Kaduna, I'm from Kaduna State. So when I was growing up in Kaduna, I remember watching Titanic in a really small, it's a cinema, but it was a small room that was just set up, and it was proper, like, you know, big screen and everything. So, but I think over time it kind of died off, and I don't think we have any cinemas there left. So definitely I think setting one up back home in Kaduna, small community, you know, affordable, that people can come and watch, I think that would be a great one.
Yeah. So what are your top three movies, top three cinema movies that you, you know, you've experienced and you love?
Top three cinema movies. I think Titanic has to be number one, because that's one, you know, memory I can never forget. I think 300. Yeah, because I really right. I love to watch epic movies in the cinema, because I feel that's where you really enjoy it. So 300 is another one that sticks. And which other one? I might say Avatar, because that's also another one that comes to my mind. So, you know, I like movies that, you know, take advantage of the whole cinema feel, though. Yeah, so those three, I think, are
really... If you were to select a movie from 2017 that you wish you featured in, or you wish, like, if you had a choice, you could feature in that movie, Nollywood or Hollywood, what movie would it be?
Nollywood or Hollywood?
Oh, yeah, anyone. Or and Hollywood.
For Nollywood, I think it has to be the cash cow now. Wedding Party.
Hey.
They made a serious amount of money, so I would have loved to be part of that project, you know. Hollywood, it has to be one of these superhero movies. I've always dreamt of being in a superhero movie, to be honest.
Wonder Woman for me.
Wonder Woman was cool. It's cool, yeah. There was Avengers last year, so yeah.
So which of the Avengers character is it?
No, it has to be my own.
If I was a guy, it would be Thor.
Oh, you want to be?
Aye, all that muscle.
Right.
If it was Wedding Party, what character would it be?
It should be the lead character, which is Josie, I think. Bunky W's character, right?
Yes, yeah. So some people will feel like, you know, in Big Brother, people get to see your real character. Is that true? Because I feel like everybody's just in there, you know, competing for the money. So you're like, you know, whatever it takes to win. So you don't really get to see people's character. Right?
I think you're right to a particular extent, because yes, a lot of people will go there, they want to be the loud person, they want to be the entertainer, the comedian and all that. So I think people are different. Me, I didn't look at it that way. I looked at it as I wanted to be in the house for as long as possible and hopefully win the money, you know. So it worked for me to a particular point, and then yeah. So
all right, thank you very much. It's been so much fun having you on the show, on the Film House TV show. I hope you had as much fun as I did.
Yes, I did. I mean,
all right, thank you.
Yeah,
see you around. All right, thank you. All right, guys, I had so much fun chatting with Bali. He's actually a lot fun to talk to and speak with. Honestly, we can go on and on, but we have to move on to the other segments of the show. Don't go anywhere. It's still the Film House TV show. See you.
Coming up, we have a rundown of all movies currently showing in the cinemas across the country.
It doesn't look like an engagement ring, though, Trudy.
That's because it's a promise ring.
Eh?
Hey! Don't punish you! If I don't punish your entire generation!
June, from the producers of the hit movie Hire a Man, it's another blockbuster titled June. June is a romantic comedy that follows a wedding planner played by Michelle Didi, who is in search of love. The film, which was directed by Desmond Elliott, is playing now. It's Valentine's Day. Go check out June.
It shall be a designer wedding gown. It shall be made of Gucci. It shall be made of Adidas.
It is my wedding!
It is not your wedding, it is our wedding. You, me, our wedding.
And is this what you call a menu?
You are so incompetent!
Excuse me?
I paid her for a service and she hasn't done it!
I apologize.
Turn it out!
I know, I can't.
Get out! Get out!
Odds are we're not all gonna make it out of this one.
If we don't take that city, World Trade Center's just the beginning.
12 Strong tells the story of the first special forces deployed to Afghanistan after 9/11. Under the leadership of a new captain, the team must work an Afghan warlord to take down the Taliban.
There's no playbook here. We have to write it ourselves. I ain't losing one man on this team.
You could stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down.
We're fighting with horsemen against tanks.
Weapon in history is this.
There ain't no easy way out.
And if you die, that's a letter you and your wife are gonna wish you wrote.
I made her a promise. I'm coming home.
Won't back down.
12 Strong, the declassified true story of the horse soldiers.
Hey,
pay attention.
This is yours. Most important thing, keep your finger off the trigger at all times, unless you need to shoot somebody. When that happens,
3170, we're being held up.
Hold it until you run dry.
Dispatch, we are under heavy fire.
Keep your eyes open. Every cop in the country is going to be looking for us.
Den of Thieves, a gritty crime saga which follows the lives of an elite unit of the Los Angeles County Sheriff Department and the state's most successful bank robbery crew as the outlaws plan a seemingly impossible heist on the Federal Reserve Bank.
You know what this means? It means I am a member of a gang, only we have badges, which means you are done.
Come on, Vest.
Do we look like the types who arrest you?
I want to put that seat on.
Put you in handcuffs, drag you down to the station. We just shoot you. Boom. You're not the bad guys. We are.
Seem like the whole city go against me.
We're running out of time. You've seen what's happening out there.
We're coming up behind!
Hang on! Maze Runner. Young hero Thomas embarks on a mission to find a cure for the deadly disease known as the Flare. Thomas, Newt, and Frypan are the last of the Gladers, immune to the Flare virus that's infected the world's population. They invade a WKCD transport train in order to save fellow Glader, Mino.
You still care about it, don't you?
Don't lie to me!
Come on. How many kids do they have to round up? Torture. Kill. When the hell does it stop?
It stops when we find a cure. Thomas, you can save your friends. Or you can save us all.
Please, Tommy. Please.
Yes, yes, my people. It's your boy Bali, DJ Bali. You know what it is, man. Bali Rally. Keep watching the Film House TV show. Don't touch that down, man. Peace out.
Now we've come to the end of today's episode of the Film House TV show. I'm super excited about the movies coming out of the box office. And of course, I had fun hanging out with DJ Bali. I'm sure you had as much fun as I did. Thank you so much for watching. I love you so much for watching. My name is Chinonso Arubayi. Keep watching the Film House TV show.
Yes, I did. And I hope people are giving my free tickets, because I was promised some free tickets to watch some movies tonight and tomorrow. So I hope people are giving my free tickets, right? That dropped that coke, man. Answer my question.